Čau, basketbola draugi! Mani sauc Viktorija, un es esmu Eirolīgas kaislīgākā līdzjutēja un pieraiz arī sporta reportiera, kas par superkombo. Mēs atrodamies Berlīnē, un nē, mēs neiesim uz reiva ballītēm. Mēs varētu, bet nē, mēs neēdīsim Berlīnas slavenās desiņas. Oktoberfests ir beidzies, tāpēc alu arī mēs nedzersim, bet mēs ar jums sekosim Eirolīgas Final Four turnīram. Berlīnas Uber arēnā, jā, tajā pašā, kas man šobrīd ir aiz muguras. Par Eirolīgas čempionu titulu cīnīsies četras šīs sezonas spēcīgākās komandas. Stambulas Fenerbahče, Atēnu Panathinaikos, Madridas Real un Pireju Olympiakos. Tas nozīmē, ka es jums rādīšu pilnīgi visas šī turnīra aizkulises. Mēs runāsim ar Eiropas labākajiem basketbolistiem. Mēs aprunāsimies ar kaislīgākajiem Eirolīgas faniem. Ja mums būs par ko parunāt, kā arī es ņemšu līdz jūs turpat pie kortiem, tā kā jūs būsiet vienkārši metri attālumā no visiem notikumiem, kas šeit risināsies. Vai jūs esat gatavi? Jo es esmu. Bet vēl viena lieta, lai redzētu šos apskatus, jums ir jāpiesako Olībet Latvija YouTube kanālam, kā arī jāsako līdz viņiem soctīkliem Olībet Sports Bar Instagramā. Esmu gatava piedzīvojumiem, un jūs, let's go! Pirms Eirolīgas atbildīgajiem pusfināliem pati Eirolīga rīko preses konference. Lūk, jūs redzat skatuvi, uz kuras pēc īsa brīža jau kāps četri komandu galvenie treneri ar katras komandas spēlētājiem. Šobrīd mēs varam redzēt, ka sāk pulcēties žurnālisti no visas Eiropas, lai uzdot sev interesējošos jautājumus spēlētājiem. Es pačikstēšu priekšā, ka pēc pāris sekundēm arī man būs iespēja aprunāties ar spēlētājiem, bet tikmēr mēs izbaudām atmosfēru. Un vēl viena lieta, ko es gribu atzīmēt, tas ir tik fantastiski forši ierasties uz šo turnīru un satikt savus kolēģus no citām valstīm. Es jau satiku no Lietuvas savus kolēģus. Mēs apkampāmies, sabučojāmies, izrunājām basketbola lietas un tik tiešām basketbols ir tas sporta veids, kas vieno. Bet jūs turpināt sākot līdz apskatam. Presa konference ir noslēgusies, un tagad mēs stāvam interviju zonā, kur mēs tad arī aprunāsimies ar Eirolīgas spēlētājiem. Esmu satraukta, tāpat kā spēlētāji. Well, it's the time of the year Euroleague Final Four, and it's absolutely clear that all four teams came here only for one aim, to win the trophy. This will be your fifth Final Four, so what lessons and experience from previous Final Four tournaments will be most valuable for your team heading into this year's final?
I think the last year we know it was tough for us to beat one of the team of the season like Partizan. It was tough for us to win, so I think this year we handle it better because they give us a lot of experience. They give us the playoff is going to be hard to get to the Final Four. We know we got to do everything perfect to try and achieve the goal as much fast as we can. So this year we did. So luckily we got it done quickly and perfectly. So we didn't suffer that much.
There's no experience in these games. I mean, the knowledge is something coming fourth and fifth. I think the most important here is a wish to be humble, hungry for win, and of course the small things and details like rebounding, hustle balls, fouls. This will be the key for every game.
Little things are the most important things. When you try to win trophies, when you try to win championships, when you try to win big games. We've seen this year that we've lost some big games, some must-win games, and when we watch the film, we see that we made too many mistakes on little things. You can't control, when the players make great shots. You can't control yourself missing shots. You can't control turnovers and stuff like that. But the little things like boxing out, being in the right spot, not losing 50-50 balls, those are the things that you can always control, your effort on defense. So as long as we can try to be 100%, as close to 100% in those, we will definitely give ourselves a better chance.
I'm just trying to transmit my thoughts, my feelings that I had as a player. try to transmit my thoughts as a feeling. I had a coach in the different situations, you know, you try to prepare as much as you can for them without giving too much information. I know they're going through a tough time, you know, mixed emotions of excitement and nervousness for sure. But you know, it's the time to put the best possible game on the court, you know, and hopefully we can do that.
To win this EuroLeague trophy, you need to win two games. It's easy to say, but it's a lot of pressure. It's really important to be mentally ready for the battle. So what is your mentality for this tournament? Because, you know, player can be physically ready on 100%, but if the player don't fix things in his mind, there can start problems.
Yeah, I agree with you, because the most important is to be mentally ready. Physically, all the players have their routine, they make their practice that they want. Some players want more practice, some to rest. But the most important is to be mentally ready. And if you ask me, I'm thinking about the game all day and all night, how maybe it would go, how it should be, to be aggressive, offense, defense. This is the way that I approach the games.
I've had tremendous coaches throughout my my career and my life playing basketball. And one of the things they mentioned is that the biggest games should be the easiest games to play in for you, and that's because those are the games you grow up as a kid wanting to play in. Those are the games you see yourself playing in. Those are the games why you work so hard in the summer, why you do what you do throughout the season, so that way you can put yourself in those positions. And those should be the least pressure games, because it's the one you wanted the most. So you can just go out there and you can cover up a lot of nerves, a lot of mistakes, just by playing hard and trying to do the right thing and by being aggressive. So as long as you go out there, you do that, and of course you play aggressive, you play with confidence, and you do that to the best of your ability, you will calm down out there and everything will settle in a place for you.
Well, for me, the most important lesson and the most valuable all these years is saying to my guys, you know, especially guys that they get this experience for the first time, that you have to take everything from this experience and enjoy it as much as you can, because you never know if there's going to be another time and when it's going to be another time to have this experience. Other than that, you know, just you got to come here and compete. You know, it's a blessing for us to have the opportunity to be on the center court, you know, among the four best teams in Europe. This is what sports and professionalism is about. You know, you want to be competing on this game, so don't take it heavily, like it's a burden, you know, like it's pressure. Just enjoy it and do your best, you know, and enjoy every moment, and whatever comes in the end of it, and you never know, the result might be great for us. You know, if you are relaxed and you play your kind of game, what brought you here the whole season, what made you successful the whole season, maybe this is the key, you know, for the Final Four.
Good luck. Question. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
Latvia. Kristaps nice. Porzingis.
I would say Roman Smits.
Oh, yeah, Roman Smits. He's a
man. He's a man. Of course he is. I got you, Roman. Shame on you. I not say Roman. He's in EuroLeague.
Basketbal draugi, tikko mēs esam nointervējuši arī visu četru komandu spēlētājus, kā arī vienu treneru, un tas nozīmē, ka mēs varam ar jums gatavoties tieši tā pirmajiem EuroLeagues pusfināliem. Vēlreiz atgādināšu, ka līdz šiem apskatiem jūs varat sekot Olibet Latvija YouTube kanālā, kā arī redzēt šī turnīra aizkulises, tā teikt, ieskatus Instagramā Olibet Sports Bar. Tiekamies! Un basketbols tiešām ir foršs! Čau!